Welcome to Contox Hockey. On this show, we talk anything ice hockey or hockey related. So my first segment is going to be top hockey news. Well, we're just going to be talking about the Las Vegas Golden Knights, the newest team to the NHL, going into effect 2017-2018 season. But with this, there will be an expansion draft. Now, the rules for the expansion draft are, clubs will have two options for players they wish to protect in the expansion draft. 7 forwards, 3 defensemen, and 1 goaltender, which is option A, or B, 8 skaters, forwards and defensemen, and 1 goaltender. And then there's a bunch of, you know, no movement clauses with people's contracts. So getting into my lineup would be first, for the first line of forwards, Rick Nash from the New York Rangers, Tyler Bozak from the Toronto Maple Leafs, and Jacob Silverberg from the Anaheim Ducks, which would be a good, strong, you know, you got Rick Nash, who was a good player, but, you know, he's slumping now with the New York Rangers wanting a trade, which will be good for the Rangers and both parties. Minot Pulat from the Edmonton Oilers, Darren Helm from the Detroit Red Wings, and Kaye Janarok from the Nashville Predators. Good second line, it'd be pretty strong. Michael Roffey from the Philadelphia Flyers, Vladislav Nemestok from the Tampa Bay Lightning, and Jimmy Hayes from the Boston Bruins, which is a good, strong, you know, third line. All these guys are big, you know, players. Brad Richardson from the Arizona Coyotes, Adam Lowry from the Winnipeg Jets, and Lee Stepniak from the Carolina Hurricanes. And now, that was the fourth line, but now here we go to some of the scratches or, you know, spare players if one guy gets injured. Brent Rinchie from the Dallas Stars, Hunter Shinnerock from the Calgary Flames, and Brendan Gaughan from the Vancouver Canucks, with a little bit of help from Charles Hundon of the Montreal Canadiens. That would round up all my forwards. Now to defensemen. Calvin DeHaan from the New York Islanders, Dennis Savard from the Columbus Blue Jackets, which would be a good, you know, two pair of defensemen. I mean, all these guys can be mixed matching anyway. Alec Martinez from the Los Angeles Kings, Mark Pisick from the Florida Panthers, Paul Martin from the San Jose Sharks, Matthew Dumba from the Minnesota Wild, and for the spares, Mark Methot from the Ottawa Senators, Ben Lovejoy from the New Jersey Devils, and Nikita Zadorov from the Colorado Avalanche. And now on to the goaltenders, which I'm going to talk about more in depth since I'm a goaltender. Matt Murray would be my first pick from the Pittsburgh Penguins. Coming off a Stanley Cup win, only being 22 years old, would be a great pick for the new team. And then for my second would be Scott Darling from the Chicago Blackhawks. He's going to be an elite goaltender in the future. Definitely could be a starter for them between Matt Murray and him. And then my spares would be Linus Ullmark from the Buffalo Sabres. You know, strong, you know, he'd be a good AHL starter, but good backup. And Phoenix Copley from the St. Louis Blues. He's got a lot of potential. He's playing with the Chicago Wolves right now. I like to see big things from him in the future. And now for my second part of my top hockey news. Big changes in the NHL for goaltenders. Smaller pants. Now, what they're trying to do is allow more goals, you know, more goals, increase fans. But I don't want a 5-6 game. I want a 1-2 game where, you know, you're on your edge of the seat and it's like, what's going to happen? Not just, oh, okay, they're going to score, you know, every other period. So that rounds off my top hockey news. Hi, welcome back to Contox Hockey. I'm here today with my guest, Eric Zeitlin, and he coaches for Riverside Brookfield High School. Hi, Eric, how are you doing today?
Great, doing well.
So, when did you start playing ice hockey?
I started playing roller hockey first before I played ice hockey. And I was probably, 4 or 5 years old. And then in my backyard, where I in my house in my backyard, there's a kind of like a divot in the yard. And it freezes in the winter, it rains, and then when it gets cold, it freezes. So I remember when I was a little guy, it froze back there, and I had a pair of ice skates in my garage. And I was just so intrigued by watching the Hawks and watching hockey on TV that I just kind of fell in love with it at an early age. So I went back in the backyard and started playing back there, kind of basically taught myself how to play, how to ice skate, I should say. And then as far as organized hockey goes, I started at age 7. The first team I played on was Franklin Park Panthers. Actually, our home rink that we play for the North Stars at Franklin Park. It's just kind of stuck with me ever since.
So when did you decide you wanted to start coaching hockey?
I decided to start coaching hockey after I graduated college and realized that my playing career, not necessarily sailed, but I wasn't going to be playing anymore competitively. So I want to stay in the game, and you know, what better way than coaching, right? I mean, I guess I could have been like an equipment manager or something, but still wanted to be in the game, and I enjoy working with other people, especially.
Now, what's the first team you started coaching for?
The Oak Park Ice Bears.
Okay. So did you go to RB?
Yes.
Now, did you play for the RB hockey team while you were studying here?
I did, yes. I actually started it.
How was your experience with the hockey team here?
It's great. I loved it. Got a chance to be on a team with a bunch of guys that you went to school with. It was really fun.
Then what college did you go to?
St. Mary's University in Winona, Minnesota.
And did you play hockey there?
I did, yes.
How would you describe the college hockey experience?
College hockey is competitive. It's demanding. It's demanding. I would also say it's a lot of fun. It is fun, but in order for it to be fun, you've got to maintain your skill because it's an extremely high level of hockey.
And how often were you on the ice when you were playing college? Like, how many days a week were you practicing?
Every day.
Every day?
Yeah, 5 or 6 days a week.
And then how would you describe, like, your coaching style?
I believe that a good coach should be a player coach and be able to relate with his players individually and realize that every single player on his team is different, but at the same time still maintaining that discipline.
And then how do you run your practices so they feel that they're, you know, ready for the game?
With the North Stars?
Yeah.
I try to make sure that every practice, you know, everyone shows up and we have the mindset realizing that we're there with a purpose, and that purpose is the practice itself is the purpose. We want to make it the best possible practice.
Okay, and then when did you start coaching with the North Stars?
Just this past year.
Thanks for coming in, and hope good luck for the season.
Thanks for having me, Con. It's great to be here.
Yeah. After these few messages, we will be doing a gear review on some goalie skates. Stay tuned. Hi, welcome back to Con Talks Hockey. Right now, we're doing a review of my Bauer 1.7 goalie skates. So to start off on these goalie skates, these are Bauer's like lower end skate with the Vertex 2 cowling on here. This is a 4mm steel blade. Personally, I cut it half an inch. So the big step they took with this type of goal skate is the anatomical design here on the ankle area, which when you're going like this, you get more support and it's better for backside pushes. The Vertex 2 cowling gives you, you know, better attack angles, so you can go sharper down onto the ice. And personally, I feel that it's one of the better goal skates on the market. You get the new anatomical design on it. And then you also get the very sharp looking design with the gray, white, and yellow, which I enjoy a lot, and it makes you look real good on the ice. But since this is a lower end model of the 1.7, it goes 1.7, 1.9, and then NXG. You get a little bit of softer boot. As you can see, I can squeeze like that. So it gives you a lot of leeway. These are heat moldable, but I haven't not heat molded them before. I prefer to use wax slices on these. It gives you a little bit tighter feel. And then the big advantage that I feel that I get with the Vertex 2 is it's a little bit outer on the cowling area. So when the puck hits you, like I've gotten hit right here, most guys can actually break their toe like that, but it's farther out, so it just hits it and all the impact goes into here. And then you get a lot of, it's a lot higher with the 4mm steel. But yeah, so That's it for my review. I would give these goal skates a 8 out of 10. The pros is the Vertex 2 and the new design on the ankle area. But the cons are the boot is kind of soft, so it'll get softer as you go along, and it won't stay in shape for a long time. So yeah, after these short messages, we'll be back. Thanks for watching. Hi, welcome back to Con Talks Hockey. Right now, I'll be commentating on some plays. So the first play I have is the Calgary Flames against the Minnesota Wild. So as you can see, they're passing on the defensive line, and he puts it into the hash marks, and they score. But what the really big thing that's happening right now is that Monahan goes for the screen, which makes it very, you know, very hard for the goaltender to see the puck. So I think it gives the Calgary Flames a big advantage. If they keep doing this, they'll do big things in the NHL. I mean, so my next play is the Chicago Blackhawks against the Minnesota Wild. Ryan Hartman is going to be who we're going to focus on. So he goes into the zone with Hinostroza, and Hinostroza throws into the middle. What they're all doing is they're doing a three, so one on one side, one on one side, and one in the middle. So which really lets to have really a lot of options, and he passes right into the middle, crashing the net. They go top cheddar and get a good goal right there, goal of the game. The next play I have is Sean Monahan snipes the corner. So it's Sean Monahan and the Calgary Flames versus the New Jersey Devils. So what they're doing right now is they're in the zone doing a breakout, and once again passing it right into the middle, which is seems to be a big thing in the NHL these days, is if you just pass it right in the middle, you'll get a really good shot off. So he passes it right into the middle and goes top cheddar on Corey Schneider, and which is a really good goal. I mean, players should be looking up to these. To Sean Monahan, who is doing all these big things, which, you know, screening and then, you know, having a great shot. And my final play is the Detroit Red Wings versus the Boston Bruins. So Athanasio goes in and is on a really on a breakaway. And he dekes to Carrascal three times, kind of like in the Mighty Ducks, and goes for a great goal. Which I'm trying to show you is how you have to have speed. Because once you have the speed, then you're done. I mean, once you have this, if you have good speed, good shot, I mean, you'll be good in the NHL. And so thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.